Good day, all. I'm very grateful for this invitation and possibility to share with you my understanding on what's going with online exams, what's going on with the anxiety connected with them in this very specific time of pandemic. My name is Emilia Stoymenova-Tsanevska, and I am psychology professor, licensed health psychologist, psychotherapist, and supervisor, Dean of Faculty of Humanities and Social Sciences at International Balkan University. Working more than 30 years in the field of clinical and health psychology, and 25 in the field of psychotherapy and education, I'm more than invited to share with you my understanding of what we have faced and what is challenging in here and now. This situation, very highly stress-saturated, like the exam plus pandemia, is really something that bothers all of us. And definitely, what we are experiencing today is a lot of worries, a lot of irritableness, a lot of incapacity to have a proper dream, some neurovegetative problems, some problems connected with psychosomatic reactions, and still we don't know where they're coming from. They're coming from what we are experiencing in here and now. And what we are experiencing in here and now has to be acknowledged. This period that is prolonged as such is creating a lot of disturbances. What we have to face, very important these days, are the upcoming exams. Probably they will be online. We don't have experience with that, and we have to acknowledge that. On the other hand, we know that for some people, online experience could provoke even more anxiety. What to do with that is the question. Some information at the very beginning, because without information, we couldn't really start to use all of our support systems that are so much necessary in here and now. What we know today is that even Imperial London College did the online exams with 280 medical students on their final year, on the sixth year, and they are the first one from those very highly ranked universities that created online experience and their online exams, and their experience are very good. Also, it's clear that we somehow have prepared for this, and there are already some research connected with that, that are giving us information that students are fond of such experience because probably they are having more capacity and more somehow inner support for doing this. What the obstacles are, mainly are connected with technical issues and unclarity about the guidelines. Of course, they also pointed on some very specific and positive things, like staying at home, being capable to use the commodity of the home and the whole support that is connected with that. Still, the anxiety is present. We have learned that those that are experiencing more anxiety during the classroom exams are having less anxiety during online exams, and vice versa. But still, anxiety is present. Exams are stressors of the highest rank. So, what to do with them? Please, be aware. Are you excited or are you anxious? In order to stay excited and really to do the best your exams, try to activate all of your support systems. Otherwise, anxiety will overwhelm. Anxiety is nothing more but excitement without support. Keep this in mind, dear students. The most important thing now I will point is that when we are on exams, what frightens us the most? Probably how we will present ourselves. Our ideal self-esteem is suffering because we don't know the results. We have to boost it. How? Using the best we possess. We have to adjust our cognitive style to the new situation. We have to adjust ourselves. And how could we do that? Through activation of the support systems. Which means what? First of all, in this very moment, 20% and more from the population is dealing with anxiety and all its variation. I'll be very glad if you don't enter in that subpopulation. How to support? There are several support systems I'll point now. The first one is body posture. So please feel comfortable in your body and prepare for the exam. The second is breathing. We couldn't breathe if we are very much under the stress, if we are frightened. But when we breathe, we put the oxygen that is so necessary for the function of our brain cells. So make the breathing exercises. Then continue with interpersonal support. Interpersonal support could be gained from your lecturers, from your peers, from your family. Also, the most important thing, as we know also from the research, is technical aspects. Prepare well. Check your computer. Check your Wi-Fi connection. If all is fine, then always keep in mind that probably something could happen. Give yourself enough time to readjust to it. If you didn't manage, always ask your lecturer for a hand. Inform him, and I know that you'll figure out how you could do the best in that situation. Things happen, we have just to adjust to it. So, for me, one point more before I end with this is keep in mind when you enter in your room for the exam at home to make the best atmosphere you could. Put your favorite flower if you like it. Put something that could support you. Choose your armchair, favorite one. Make clear desk. Take water. Move away pets or younger siblings. Prepare all your books and notes. These kind of exams seems that are very easy, but they are not. Open book exam is not easy if you haven't learned enough before. So learn it continuously in order really to gain good knowledge, which means a good cognitive support. Make notes in your books, in your handbooks, on your writings, so you could easily search if some unclarity appeared. Please don't stuck to a question that you do not know. Just continue and then take your time to come back. Set your alarm clock 10 minutes before the end of the exam to give you a sign so you could recheck what you have done. If you prepare all of this, which means you activate your body support and the breathing, which means good armchair that supports you, fresh room, good environment, water and all stuff, you already satisfied the needs for this support. Cognitive support, you already, I know, you're building it since you're learning hard. So everything that you have prepared, keep close to you. Then third thing, interpersonal. If you think that someone could really give a hand, that is your lecturer. And of course, some of your peers. Exchange with them. Ask for clarification. Ask for pre-exam. When we have the experience, we are making demystification, and that is one of the best antidotes of the anxiety. And finally, instrumental support that is connected with all technical aspects. Please check it once, twice. At the end of the day, be aware we couldn't control everything. Even just the electricity could shut down. Immediately share that with the lecturer and be sure that you'll gain support. I think that I could give a lot of other advices and exchanges with you. Still, I think that less is more. At the end, instead of saying goodbye to all of you, I'll just say stay safe, stay sane, and stay high-spirited. And see you soon at IBU premises.